collectively gathered by the House of Representatives over years, and the institution keeps them well. That is why, from my entry in 2004 of the 13th Congress until today, I have observed the observance of that well-kept tradition. The two highest positions in government, namely the office of the President and the office of the Vice President, were duly accorded with respect and deference. I have observed that. That's why I have relayed to you earlier in 2022, the Honorable Libana, invoking courtesy, took him only 13 minutes to dispose the office of the Vice President. And that was quickly moved, quickly seconded by no less than our majority leader. That was in 2022. I'm not going my record, Madam Chair. 2023, I said, not no less than the presidential son, our own senior deputy majority leader, stood up and said that in line with the time-honored tradition of according courtesy to the office of the Vice President, I move to terminate the budget briefing of the OBP. And I can recall the Honorable Castro strongly objected. No, that's in 2023. This is by the record. And she objected, but her objections were rejected by the committee because the committee already terminated the proceedings. And she kept on requesting, Madam Chair, that she makes at least a manifestation. And she was unable to do that because the proceedings were terminated. So that, what I am saying, from 2004, when I entered these halls, these hallowed halls, hanggang punto sa sinasabi kong 2023, we have kept the tradition. Ngayon po, kung ano-ano ng mga tanong ang ginawa, in 2023, 22 minutes, 2022, 13 minutes, at the ball, pinagawayan na po yung budget earlier, at ngayon, we're about to quarrel again on the budget. Ang tanong ko nga po ngayon, dahil nga po sa nangyayari ngayon sa budget ng Office of the Vice President, and despite her manifestation that she will no longer defend her budget because I will forgo my opportunity to defend the budget of the OBP for 2025 by way of question and answer, and I will leave to the House of Representatives to decide such proposal as presented. We cannot even accept such kind of answer, Madam Chair. What do we need her to articulate for? So, ang pinag-uusapan po natin, wala na po ba yung respeto sa tradisyon na yun? Kagaya po ng binabanggit ko, every time mag-interpellate po dito, Madam Chair, because of that tradition, it's always the member of the minority who will start the interpellation. Ang dami po.
who's unmoved is lost. Change my
Thank you.